did this guy just say, I have cancer? And then did he just say it can't be cured?
As a physician, I didn't even realize the prevalence of Asian female non-smoker having a higher incidence of developing lung cancer.
I would say my family was more concerned for me than I was. I felt like we got it early.
I felt like cancer had taken so much of my life already, and here we are again. taking more away from me.
Some of the challenges were just getting past the gatekeepers.
I couldn't get any answers. I went through several primary doctors. They didn't listen. It's difficult to know anything about African American if you rarely deal with them in a medical sense. If they would have listened, I think we could have gotten past a lot of those things.
One of the barriers is insurance. They didn't want to pay for MRI, all that stuff. It takes time.
In the past, we've had issue with a doctor who we felt was not open to treating gay patients. My doctor is not gay, but he's understanding of John and my relationship. He understands that we're a team. We were making this decision as a family.
The one thing that struck me about cancer disparities, so I got the opportunity to go to a breast cancer conference, and I noticed that they grouped Pacific Islanders and Asians together. And that does a disservice to everyone in that group.
The current state of health disparities, as we think about it in the United States today, is an interesting one. We've made some progress, but we certainly have areas where we need to make more progress. So overall, what I would say is the net is net positive, net progress, but more work to do. Equity and disparities are not just located to just a racial group, but it's geography. It's also whether you're LGBTQ.
The Tampa LGBTQ community was tremendously supportive and also beyond. I have a lot of friends. Everybody was, as a team, sort of just stepped in and really helped.
We need to be much more open about how we see the importance of ZNA, Zip Code Neighborhood Association, and the role it plays in our health.
I live on the Cattaraugus Indian Reservation of the Seneca Nation.
I live in Glendora, California.
And I've been living in the Bay Area.
In Humacao, Puerto Rico.
A small town in Pennsylvania.
I live in Houston, Texas.
Live in Tampa, Florida.
I live in Virginia.
And I live in Oahu, Hawaii.
This report, I believe, is a call to action, actually seeing people as they live. How do we make sure that access and availability, whether it's getting the next test or the next screening, or whether it's getting the next miracle drug, how do we make it accessible for everyone?
After my surgery, we discussed clinical trials. And since we live in Hawaii, that was a major obstacle. A lot of them were on the mainland. To like fly over, take time off of work, and it's just impossible.
When we talk about getting more people onto clinical trials, you know why that's important? It's because maybe not all the drugs act the same way on everybody. Not just because your race, but maybe because the place and space that you also live.
They were giving me 3 treatments every 15 days. They said it's going to be a 2-year oncology trial. They gave me hope.
I think we need to make our trials much more accessible to all people that are suffering with cancers.
I knew from the very beginning, you will have to advocate for yourself. I didn't want there to be a chance that I wasn't here because I didn't fight hard enough.
I learned very early on how fortunate I was to be diagnosed at an early stage. I knew that my voice mattered and advocacy kind of became a passion.
Through my experience, I am an advocate for my Asian communities. I participate in the FAN study.
The ACR is trying to reach out to communities, trying to actually work with folks like the NIH and other cancer centers around the country to understand that it is important that we diversify as much as we can our workforce.
I'm doing really well. I just crossed the 10-year mark. I feel like I've won the lottery.
I feel great today, actually. I'm doing well. Swimming, biking, walking, very active.
I am doing really, really well right now. No evidence of disease for my breast cancer. Just about 8 years on my stomach cancer.
I'm optimistic about our future. This is actually a call to action to alert folks that there's something that can be done with more federal funds.
More focus on the ethnic minorities and underserved population with a focus to increasing access to healthcare. There is definitely a language barrier for Asian patients. They might not be able to express their symptoms or seek out medical attention.
Funding for programs that provide rides, provide patient navigators, having someone walk you through what your next step should be to be able to move forward in your own treatment.
I think we need to talk about really the social economics of it as well. We have people who unfortunately don't have access of care.
I would definitely like to tell Congress, thank you for funding this program.
Exactly.
The research clinical trials.
With more federal funds, with more investments into science to generate the basic research that would be translated into medicines to have better knowledge of how do we get them out to more people. We have to will it into action. And that takes all of us.
This is your one chance. And if not for you, then who? You got to fight for yourself.